There are new changes to contact tracing in Indiana when it comes to exactly who will be contacted and how. Our Nikki Dementri is working for you by taking a look at these changes and asking the Marion County Contact Tracing Program, what's next?
Let me be clear. We are not giving up on contact tracing.
But the rules behind contact tracing in Indiana are changing once again. Dr. Christina Box announced Wednesday the discontinuation of outbound calls to non-household close contacts of those infected with COVID-19.
We've reviewed our contact tracing data and determined that about 60% of our non-household close contacts fail to respond to our repeated calls, texts, or other outreach.
These individuals will still get an initial text message, but Box says the move is to help support the vaccine rollout effort.
These changes should not significantly impact our contact tracing.
What do these changes mean for the average Hoosier?
So what I've been telling people is at this point, our transmission is so high, you should assume anytime you go out in public, anytime you leave your house, you're potentially exposed to COVID-19.
Shandy Dearth with IUPUI says as the pandemic evolved, so is tackling contact tracing.
So you use contact tracing to kind of control the cases, control the spread. But what we've seen is that we've also been the conduit between social services and the community.
Since midsummer, IUPUI has worked hand in hand with Marion County and the city of Indianapolis. $10.3 million from the city was granted to the university's Fairbanks School of Public Health to aid with the efforts. Dearth heads the project.
We don't just operate a call center where everyone takes in the next call. We've actually specialized our teams. So we have a team that specializes in K-12 cases, long-term care cases.
The grant was used to hire, train, and manage 300 contact tracers. Currently, there are around 160 in the program. Dearth says the new changes doesn't necessarily put strain on the local health department.
We have shifted gears a little bit more, so we have added more people into our call center and we've added an additional supervisor.
The initial funding for this program did end on December 31st, but for now, this program is continuing. Dearth says she's been told both the city and county health departments are looking for additional funding. Working for you, Nikki Dementri, WRTV.
It should be pointed out that the latest stimulus bill does include funding towards contact tracing efforts. Regardless of when that money comes down, a city official told WRTV it is committed to finding funding to continue the program. As for the Marion County Health Department, the program has been, quote, a tremendous asset in helping with contact tracing, according to the city. Dearth expects contact tracing efforts will be needed until the summer.